I can't stand bullies. This caught my attention. A landlord decides to do this to a student leasing from him. Here it is.
Have you ever seen one of these before?
I've seen one of these.
You know what it is?
I know what it is. Are you gonna treat me with it?
No.
Okay, then.
I just want to make sure you know it's here. You're really stupid. I would protect myself.
Why would you protect yourself?
Why would I protect myself?
Yes. Did I threaten you?
I have a right to protect myself.
Did I threaten you?
Did you what?
Did I threaten you?
Threat me?
Yeah.
Did I?
Yeah. Why? What if I don't? If I go to the kitchen, what are you gonna do? You're gonna shoot me?
We'll see what I do. I didn't threaten to shoot you.
But you said if you go to the kitchen and you have the gun with you, what are you gonna do?
If I have the gun with me, maybe you should figure it out.
So
you think you're so smart?
So you're gonna
shoot me? You figure out what I'm going to do.
What are you gonna do? You gonna shoot me?
I didn't say that. I said figure it out. Figure it out.
Okay, I'll figure it out. So go to the kitchen.
What?
I will still go to the kitchen.
Let's put the picture up for mass of this landlord, who is obviously a villain and Gargamel. The man is unknown. We do not have all of his information. And the student's identity and the school he attends is private for now, but I do have more background. According to U Mountain Episada on Reddit, this took place in Denton, Texas, a college town with few places to live. The cops were called, but they saw, and I quote, no direct threat, apparently. These are a few updates this user has been giving regarding the incident. Let's put those updates up. It says, and I quote, I'm not the person in the video, just a fellow classmate. The guy's renting a room in the house. He was trying to move, and the landlord was threatening him with a gun so that he wouldn't have to return deposit. The student, this is the next one. The student is out of the house. Police have done nothing. School is involved. Lawyer soon. Local news, no response. And then the next one. Apparently, there is a longer full video, but they're waiting to get it from the student involved. It says, I'm working to get the full thing, talking about the video. The student told me he had multiple videos of racist comments being made towards him, and a full version of this video. Listen, I want to tell you that I heard your cry here. I heard your plea for somebody to get involved and to report the facts as they happen to you. Now, the local news may not have picked this up, but I decided to pick it up. I'm encouraging you to contact me, contact us, so that we can get the rest of the story and be an advocate for you. If you experience this kind of racism in a systematic way, which I believe you did, let us know so we can expose it. All right? Developing story. Dina, thoughts?
Yeah, if he wasn't planning on moving, I would have said, get out. I've covered enough criminal cases, and you never know how someone's gonna respond. It's not even almost worth having a conversation with the person. And then definitely, I mean, here you are the best Yelp situation, but get out and do whatever kind of Yelp reviews you can, and then go to the school, because he is a student. I'm sure there is some sort of liaison for something like this. But if you ever feel like you're unsafe, I think the person should always leave and then deal with your rights afterwards. Because too many times, this sometimes can really end poorly.
Yeah, and I've seen situations like this before where a person will pull out a gun, make a veiled threat, slight threat, say things like this guy said, right? What you think I'm going to do? And I've seen them get arrested. I've seen them get charged with things like felony menacing, right? That did not happen here, according to the student or according to the student's friend. This did not happen. When the police came, they decided there was nothing that could result in an arrest. Have you seen a person do something like this before, where they pulled out a gun, they were making these kinds of, you know, slight threats, but they did get arrested because menacing can be an actionable charge? Have you seen that before?
I think so. And maybe one here, it's his own home. Yeah. That could have played into this. And it's Texas and they love their guns. And that depends a lot too.
I think you concluded it right there when you said it's Texas. All right.